So with the season finale for the first season of The Bad Batch out and the entire first season now available on Disney+, I figured it's a good chance to look back at the season and my thoughts on the show as a whole. So this will be one of the few episodes where I actually just talk about my opinions about something. I'm Colin, and this is Sci-Fi Deep Dive. Remember, if you enjoy this video, to head down below and hit that subscribe button. It should go without saying that this video will contain spoilers for the entirety of Season 1 of The Bad Batch, so if you haven't seen it yet, consider clicking up here to watch something else. So with all of Season 1 of The Bad Batch out, we now know the story of this squad of clone troopers immediately following Order 66 and leading all the way up to the sacking of Kamino. As a whole, the show tugged at our heartstrings a little bit and showed us the galaxy beginning the transition from the Galactic Republic to the Galactic Empire. Well, my first thoughts when I heard that they were making a show all about The Bad Batch was kind of like, why? I think a lot of people shared those thoughts. Like, why focus an entire series on this group of side characters that appeared in one arc of the Clone Wars? In fact, the show didn't really seem to have a ton of promise until I heard the era it would be taking place in. That period of time immediately following the end of the Clone Wars has fascinated me for a very long time, and I've always wanted to see more content focused in those immediate first few years of the Empire. So when I heard that The Bad Batch was going to take place during that period of time, it made me a lot more interested in the show as a concept. And when we started to actually see episodes, the show absolutely did not disappoint. Not only does it look beautiful, it's one of the, I would say, prettiest Star Wars animated shows we've seen so far, but it tells a fascinating story of a galaxy changing and a squad trying to find their place in a new environment. We get a great look at the clones as they transition from being these personable, lovable characters that we see in the Clone Wars to sort of unthinking flesh droids, for lack of a better word. And we get to see the beginning of the Empire transitioning away from using clones and into using something closer to the stormtroopers we see in the original trilogy. We get a great look at how the Empire is starting to affect the worlds that have fallen under its control. Worlds like Pantora, which may have seen some action during the Clone Wars, suddenly falling under Imperial occupation. And we see the early stages of rebellion on worlds that we know would be a problem later on. Planets like Ryloth, where the Free Ryloth movement would eventually rise up and almost overthrow the Empire. At least, throw the Empire off of Ryloth. All in all, we get a great look at how the galaxy transitions and how these characters sort of adapt to a new world. This squad has to find their way in a world where not only are clone troopers not a premier fighting force anymore, but the government they were originally fighting for, the Republic, no longer exists, and the successor state, the Empire, isn't looking out for their best interests. In fact, some would say at times it appears that the Empire is working directly against the clone troopers. And that transitionary period brings us a lot of very stunning visual changes, particularly old Republic vehicles that we're familiar with seeing serving the Republic military, sort of serving the more sinister purposes of the Imperial military. Things like LAAT gunships swooping in and dropping off clone troopers not to liberate an area from Separatist control, but to carry out an arrest. Things like Venator-class Star Destroyers being used to bombard civilian facilities. Which brings me to one of the most poignant moments of the series, and I think one that sums up the series as a whole absolutely perfectly, the last two episodes, where we see the Empire evacuate and slag what's left of Kamino. Specifically, what's left of Topoka City, the capital of Kamino. Seeing these facilities, which have been part of Star Wars since Attack of the Clones and played prominent roles in the Clone Wars, empty, abandoned, and eventually destroyed, was absolutely heart-wrenching, and it definitely drove the idea home that this is the end of an era. The era with the clone troopers and the Jedi and the Clone Wars was over, replaced with the darker days of the Galactic Empire. And no visual element could convey that quite as perfectly as burning something as iconic as Topoka City. All in all, I really loved The Bad Batch. It gave us an amazing look at an era of Star Wars that I definitely would like to see more of. It showed us a little bit of how the galaxy really transitioned from the Galactic Republic to the vastly different Galactic Empire. All in all, awesome show. I'm really looking forward to Season 2. But if you want more of the usual content from this channel, something more factual and analytical, and you want to stay on topic, I'll leave a link up here to my video all on the history of Topoka City. But I want you to let me know down in the comments what your thoughts on The Bad Batch were, having seen the entirety of Season 1. Did you like it, or is there anything you would have liked to see done differently? And if you have any topics you'd like to see me cover from Star Wars, leave them down below in the comments. And last but not least, if you enjoyed this video, head down below, hit the like button, the subscribe button, and the bell icon so you get notified when I upload new videos. So for Sci-Fi Deep Dive, I'm Colin, and I will see you next time.